This is the video lecture on financial ratios. Now, a financial ratio is a formula, and it's a formula that demonstrates the relationship between various financial elements. The great thing about financial ratios is that they actually tell us a lot about a company, and we can actually use the answer that we get from these financial ratios to judge the company and to analyze the strengths and weaknesses, and to also determine if the company has been successful or if perhaps they've had some problems. So as simple as these financial ratio formulas are, they're actually very informative. They do tell us a lot about a company. And in the case of all the financial ratios that we're going to cover in this particular lecture, we need to not only know the formula, but we also need to know how to calculate that ratio, and perhaps most importantly, when we get an answer, we need to know what that answer says about the company. We have to be able to analyze and interpret the answer that we get from the ratio. Now, the first formula that we're going to learn is called the current ratio. This is a very simple, very straightforward financial ratio. The formula would be current assets divided by current liabilities. Now think about it. We know what assets are. Those are the positive things that we own in the business. We know what the liabilities are. Those are the debts. But what does that mean, current? Well, current means 1 year or less. So all the assets that we have in the current year versus all the debts that we have in the current year, that's what the current ratio is based on. And this formula is going to tell us if we're covered in the current year, if we have enough money to pay our debts. Now, when I calculate the current ratio, how do I interpret the answer? I'm looking for an answer of at least one or more. The higher the answer is, the better. But if I have a current ratio less than one, that's a real sign of trouble for the company. So if you look at this example, we're saying that this company had $250,000 in total current assets versus $100,000 in current liabilities. It's very easy and simple to actually calculate the current ratio, and in this case it would be 2.5. But what's even more important is analyzing what that answer means. What does that answer mean for the company? Well, it's more than one, so that's a good thing. And I said the higher it is, the better. So in this case, what that really means is that in the current year, for every dollar that we owe, we potentially have $2.50 to cover it. So you see how that works. The higher that is, the better. And if we ever had a current ratio less than one, that would definitely be a bad sign. That would signal that we don't have enough money to cover our liabilities. So we always want to see a good, healthy current ratio for every company. The next formula is called the acid test. This is going to be very similar to the current ratio. The difference here is that this is a more strict version of the current ratio. So instead of using all the current assets, it only uses three of them in particular. And these three are the most liquid of all assets. Now, what does that mean when we say liquid? What we mean is the more liquid an asset is, the easier it is to turn it into cash. Turning something into cash means to liquidate. So we want to have assets that we can get the cash out of fairly quickly. So this formula, we have cash plus short-term investments plus receivables divided by current liabilities. So you see how it's a little different. It's not all the current assets. It's just these three in particular. And why these three? Well, think about it. Cash can't get any more liquid than that. It's already cash money. Short-term investments, we're going to sell them in the short term and get the money. Receivables, that's where people owe us money. So these are the most liquid of all assets. If you look at this example, this company had $100,000 cash, $25,000 in short-term investments, $10,000 in receivables, divided by total current liabilities of $150,000, they got an acid test of 0.9. Now, just like the current ratio, I really wish this would be higher. I'd like to see this be at least one or more, because what this answer tells me is that for every dollar that they owe, according to the more strict version of current ratio, the acid test, they've only got 90 cents. So ideally, this would be a little bit higher than this. So you see how it's a more strict version. You're only using the most liquid of the assets. The next financial ratio or formula is called working capital. Now this is going to show us how much money we have to work with. It's the current assets minus the current liabilities. So if a company has total current assets of $250,000 minus current liabilities of $100,000, that leaves $150,000. So that means we have $150,000 potentially to work with. That is our working capital. So in this situation, we want this answer to be as high as possible. The more this is, the more money we have to work with. The next financial ratio is called accounts receivable turnover. Now this is the first time we've actually had a turnover ratio. We're actually going to have two different ones of these. What are turnover ratios? Well, turnover means to get rid of something and replace it. So accounts receivable turnover, that's going to tell us how quickly are we collecting the money and then replacing it with a new receivable. So we actually want that to be as high as possible. The formula would be net sales divided by average accounts receivable. So in this case, a company had $500,000 of net sales, and in terms of receivables, notice that we see two different amounts. They had a certain amount of receivables at the beginning of the year and at the end. We have to have an average. So that makes this formula just a little bit more complex because it has an average in the middle of the formula. So look at what they're doing here. We're going to add the two numbers together and divide by two to get an average of the receivables. And when we do that and divide that into the 500,000, we get 8.3. So that means during the year, this company collected and replaced their accounts receivable 8.3 times. Again, the higher that number is, the better. Then we have another turnover formula. This one is the inventory turnover. And again, this is going to tell us how quickly do we get rid of our inventory and replace it. Well, think about it. What is the one thing that happens that causes us to get rid of inventory? We sold it. So this is going to tell us how quickly we're selling and then having to get new inventory. So again, I want this to be as high as possible. The formula, cost of goods sold divided by average inventory. So in this case, this company had $40,000 cost of goods sold, different amounts of inventory, but an average of the inventory, and they get an inventory turnover of 6.4. That means that 6.4 times during the year, they eliminated, sold, and replaced their inventory. The higher that is, the better. The next formula is called the profit margin. Now, this formula is going to tell us how much profit we make on all the items that we sell. And the formula is net income divided by net sales. So if we had a net income of $120,000 and we had net sales of $200,000, we divide that. The answer that we get is 0.6 or 60%. How would I interpret that answer? I would interpret that we made a 60% profit on sales. Or I could say that for every dollar that we sold, we got to keep 60 cents on the dollar in profit. So the higher that is, the better. Now on profit margin, you can also calculate profit margin for every individual product that you sell. And that just helps you make decisions about what products to purchase. So like I said, all these formulas, they're very straightforward formulas. They're very easy to memorize. They're very easy to calculate. But what's more important is actually interpreting the answer. Now in this example and in this lecture, we were just looking at individual examples. Later on, we're going to do a demonstration problem and we will calculate these same ratios for two different companies. And we will pit the two companies against each other to see who comes out with better answers. And again, this just helps us analyze a company and it helps us judge the company's performance.